गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर ऑफ नंबर थ्योरी। आई एम ऑडिबल?
यस सर। सर
ओके, थैंक यू। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड अवर सेकंड यूनिट व्हिच इज अ कॉन्ग्रुएंस थ्योरी, एंड इन दैट वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज मीन बाय कॉन्ग्रुएंस। आफ्टर दैट वी हैव सीन सम रिजल्ट्स एंड एग्जांपल्स डिपेंडिंग ऑन द डेफिनेशन ऑफ कॉन्ग्रुएंस, एंड देयर इज वन थ्योरम व्हिच इज नथिंग बट फॉर एनी आर्बिट्रेरी इंटीजर्स ए एंड बी, if a is congruent to b modulo n, if and only if a and b use the same remainder when divisible by n. Okay, now we have to see some examples and results depending on the congruence theory. Okay, screen is visible?
Yes sir.
स्क्रीन विजिबल आहे का?
Yes sir.
Screen is visible?
Yes, sir.
Screen is visible or not?
Yes, sir. It is visible.
Yes, sir.
आवाज येते का माझा?
हो सर।
ओके, थँक यू। ओके, सेकंड युनिट विच इज नथिंग बट कॉन्ग्रुएंस थेरी। Now, let n greater than 1 be a fixed integer a, b, c and d are any arbitrary integers then the following properties holds. Okay, that first one is A is congruent to A modulo n. Second one, if A is congruent to B modulo n, then B is congruent to A modulo. Third one is, if A is congruent to B modulo n, and B is congruent to C modulo n, then A is congruent to C modulo, A is congruent to C modulo n. A is congruent to C modulo. Fourth one is, if A is congruent to B modulo n, if A is congruent to B modulo n, and C is congruent to D modulo n, then A plus C is congruent to B plus D modulo n, and A into C is congruent to B into D modulo n. Fifth one is, if A is congruent to B modulo n, then A plus C is congruent to B plus C modulo n, and A into C is congruent to B into C modulo n. And sixth one is, if A is congruent to B modulo n, then A to the power k is congruent to B to the power k modulo n for some fixed positive integer k. These six properties we have to prove. Already we have given that n greater than 1 be any fixed integer, and A, B, C, and D are any arbitrary integers, then we have to prove that the following six properties holds. In first one, we have to prove that an element is congruent to itself under modulo n. In second one, if A is congruent to B modulo n, then we have to prove that B is congruent to A modulo n. That is, we have to prove that this one is symmetric. And in third one, if A is congruent to B modulo n and B is congruent to C modulo n, then we have to prove that A is congruent to C modulo n. That is transitivity. In fourth one, if A is congruent to B modulo n and C is congruent to D modulo n, then we have to prove that A plus C is congruent to B plus D modulo n, and A into C is congruent to B into D modulo n. And in fifth one, if A is congruent to B modulo n, then we have to prove that A plus C is congruent to B plus C modulo n, and A into C is congruent to B into C modulo n. And in sixth one, if A is congruent to B modulo n, then A to the power anything k, suppose k be any positive integer, then A to the power k is congruent to B to the power k modulo n. Let us see its proof. Okay. Now, given that n greater than 1 be a fixed positive integer. Okay, fixed integer. That is, as already given that n is greater than 1, it must be a positive. Okay, given that n greater than 1 be a fixed integer, and A, B, C, and D are any arbitrary integers. In first property, we have to prove that. To prove that A is congruent to A modulo n. And we know that. What is the definition of congruence? If A and B are any two integers, then A is congruent to B modulo n if n divides the difference of these two integers A and B. Then we say that A and B are congruent modulo n, that is, A is congruent to B modulo n. As here we have to prove that A is congruent to A modulo n, then we have to prove that n divides A minus A. But A minus A can be written as A minus A. A minus A is nothing but 0 into n. As A minus A is a multiple of n, then n must divide A minus A, which implies n divides A minus A. Now we have to use the definition of congruence. As n divides a minus a, which implies a is congruent to a modulo n. Okay, since any integer which is greater than 0 always divides the 0, therefore n divides a minus a. A minus a is nothing but 0 into n, that is 0. As n divides a minus a, then a must be congruent to a modulo n. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, in second one, we have to prove the symmetricity. Okay. Already we have given that a is congruent to b modulo n. Given that a is congruent to b modulo n. And when we see that a is congruent to b modulo n, if n divides difference of these two integers a and b, which implies n divides a minus b, which is from the definition of congruence. Okay, definition of congruence. As n divides a minus b, now we have to use the definition of divisibility, which implies there exists an integer k such that n into k is nothing but a minus b. Okay, now this n into k equal to a minus b can be written as, if we multiply both sides by minus 1, then we get n into minus k equal to minus of a minus b, and which is nothing but b minus a, which is nothing but n into minus k is equal to b minus a. Now here b minus a is a multiple of n, which implies by the definition of divisibility n must divides b minus a, which is from definition of divisibility. As n divides b minus a, which implies by the definition of congruence, as n divides the difference of two integers b and a, which implies b must be congruent to a modulo n, which is from definition of congruence. Okay, now in second one we have proved that if a is congruent to b modulo n, if a is congruent to b modulo n, then b is also congruent to a modulo n. So second property will be proved. Now in third one, okay, in third one, given that a is congruent to b modulo n and b is congruent to c modulo n. Okay, now as a is congruent to b modulo n, then by the definition of congruence, n divides a minus b. As n divides a minus b, which is from definition of congruence, which implies there exists some integer k such that q such that n into q is equal to a minus b for some integer q.
Sir,
yes,
maje ek friend tila join hota hai nahi.
Okay, kas तने जॉइन करा म्हणून सांग.
हां सांगितले.
नाव काय त्यांचं?
अमर जाटवे.
जॉईन करा म्हणून सांगा त्यांना लवकर, आणखीन त्या तुमची रिक्वेस्टच नाही आली. स्क्रीन इज विजिबल?
यस सर.
यस सर.
यस. ओके, एन इनटू क्यू इज नथिंग बट ए माइनस बी, व्हिच इम्प्लाइज ए इज नथिंग बट बी प्लस एन इनटू क्यू. लेट अस टेक दिस वन एज इक्वेशन वन, एंड आल्सो गिवन दैट बी इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू सी मॉड्यूलो एन, एंड आल्सो गिवन दैट बी इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू सी मॉड्यूलो एन. हियर वी हैव टू आल्सो use the definition of congruence, which implies n divides b minus c, which is again from definition of congruence. Okay, now again there exists an integer q dash such that n into q dash is nothing but b minus c for some integer q dash, for some integer q dash, okay, which is nothing but b is nothing but c plus n into q dash. Okay, let us take this one as equation 2. Now put the value of b, that is equation 2, in equation 1. We get put equation 2 in 1, we get that is value of b in equation 1, then we get a equal to b, b is nothing but c plus n q dash plus n into q as it is, which is nothing but, let us subtract c from both sides, we get a minus c is equal to n q dash plus n into q. That is, it can be written as a minus c is equal to n into q dash plus q. Now again here a minus c is a multiple of n, as q and q dash both are integers, therefore this one is nothing but n into some k, where k is nothing but q dash plus k, sorry, q dash plus q. As here a minus c is equal to n into k, that is a minus c is a multiple of n, again by the definition of divisibility, which implies n divides a minus c, which is from definition of divisibility. As n divides a minus c, then by the definition of congruence, as n divides the difference of two integers a and c, which implies a is congruent to c modulo n, which is from definition of congruence. So in this one, that is in third result, we have proved that if a is congruent to b modulo n and b is congruent to c modulo n, then a is congruent to c modulo n. This one is a transitive, therefore transitivity holds. Now we have to prove the fourth property. Okay, and in fourth one, given that a is congruent to b modulo n, again we have to use the definition of congruence and divisibility. We get n divides a minus b, which is from the definition of congruence, which implies n into some k equal to a minus b, which is from the definition of divisibility, which is equal to a equal to b plus n into k. Okay, n into k, which is equation 1. This one is for some integer k. Okay, integer k. Again, also given that, and also given that c is congruent to d modulo n. Okay, now as c is congruent to d modulo n, then by the definition of congruence, n divides c minus d. Again here we have to use the definition of divisibility, which implies n into some k dash is equal to c minus d for some integer k dash, some integer k dash, which implies c is nothing but d plus n into k dash. This one is equation 2. Okay. Now we have to prove that this one is given, that is, a is congruent to b modulo n and c is congruent to d modulo n. And from this we have obtained equation 1 and 2, that is, a equal to b plus nk and c equal to d plus n k dash. Now we have to prove that a plus c is congruent to b plus d modulo n and a into c is congruent to b into d modulo n. For that, let us add equation 1 and 2. We get adding equation 1 and 2, we get a plus c is congruent, sorry, a plus c is equal to plus c is equal to b plus d plus nk plus nk dash, which is obtained by adding the equations 1 and 2. Now this one can be written as a plus c is equal to b plus d plus n into k plus k dash. This one is nothing but a plus c, subtracting minus of b plus d on both sides, we get minus of b plus d. Minus of b minus of d get cancel on the right hand side. We get n into k plus k dash. As k and k dash both are integers, therefore its combination is again an integer, which is nothing but a plus c minus b plus d equal to n into some p, where p is equal to k plus k dash. Now, as here a plus c minus b plus d is a multiple of n, then by the definition of divisibility, n divides a plus c minus b plus d, which is from definition of divisibility. Definition of divisibility. Okay. So now we have to use the definition of congruence, as n divides the difference of a plus c minus b plus d, that is a plus c and b plus d. N divides the difference of a plus c and b plus d, which implies a plus c is congruent to b plus d modulo n. Okay, and which is from definition of congruence. So here we have proved the first part of the property 4, that is, if a is congruent to b modulo n and c is congruent to d modulo n, then a plus c is congruent to b plus d modulo n. Now we have to prove the second part. In second part, we have to prove that if a is congruent to b modulo n and c is congruent to d modulo n, then a into c is congruent to b into d modulo n. Now, as already we have taken a is congruent to b modulo n, which implies a equal to b plus nk, and c is congruent to d modulo n, which implies c equal to d plus nk dash. Now we have to take the multiplication of equation 1 and 2. We get multiply equation 1 and 2. We get, what is equation 1? A equal to b plus nk, and equation 2 is c equal to d plus nk dash, which implies a into c is nothing but b plus nk into d plus nk dash, which implies a into c is equal to b plus nk d plus nk into d plus nk dash. Okay, now this can be written. Now take the multiplication of both the brackets. We get b into d plus n into b k dash plus n k d plus n square into k k dash. Okay, now this one is a into c, which can be written as a into c is equal to b into d, plus taking n common, we get b k dash plus d into k plus n into k k dash. So which is nothing but a into c equal to b into d plus n into some p dash, where p dash is nothing but b k dash plus d k plus n k k dash. As all b, d, k dash and n are integers, then its linear combination must be an integer, and which is p dash. Now this one can be written as, after subtracting b into d on both sides, we get a into c minus b into d is equal to n into p dash, which is obtained by subtracting the term of b into d on both sides. Okay, now again, as ac minus bd is a multiple of n, which implies n divides ac minus bd, as n divides ac minus bd, by the definition of congruous, which implies ac is congruent to b into d modulo n, which is from definition of congruous. Okay, so in this result, so if a is congruent to b modulo n, and c is congruent to d modulo n, then a plus c is congruent to b plus d modulo n, and a into c is congruent to b into d modulo n. Okay, any doubt?
No sir.
Now the fifth property is, in fifth one we have to given that a is congruent to b modulo n, and we have to prove that a plus c is congruent to b plus c modulo n, and a into c is congruent to b into c modulo n for some arbitrary integer c. As a is congruent to b modulo n, then by the definition of congruence, n divides a minus b, which is from definition of divisibility. Okay, sorry, definition of congruence, which implies n into sum k is equal to a minus b for some integer k. Okay, which is nothing but a equal to b plus n into k. Let us take this one as equation 3. Okay, now add this term c on both sides. We get a plus c is equal to b plus c plus n k. Since here we have added the term c on both sides, which can be written as a plus c minus of b plus c is equal to n into k. Here just we have to take subtract the term b plus c on both sides, then we get a plus c minus of b plus c is equal to n into k. Now again, the LHS is a multiple of n, then by the definition of divisibility, which implies n divides a plus c minus of b plus c. Now as n divides the difference of these two integers a plus c and b plus c, then by definition of congruence, which implies a plus c is congruent to b plus c modulo n. So here we have proved that if a is congruent to b modulo n, then a plus c is congruent to b plus c modulo n. That is first part of the fifth property will be proved. Now we have to prove the second part, that is, if a is congruent to b modulo n, then a into c is congruent to b into c modulo n. Just multiply equation 3 on both sides by c. Multiply equation 3 on both sides by c, we get, if we multiply c on both sides, then we get a into c is equal to बी प्लस एन के इंटू सी, ये ए इंटू सी इज इक्वल टू बी प्लस एन के इंटू सी विच इज नथिंग बट ए इंटू सी इज इक्वल टू बी इंटू सी प्लस एन के सी विच इज इक्वल विच इम्प्लाइज ए इंटू सी इक्वल टू बी इंटू सी प्लस एन इंटू सम k dash, where k dash is nothing but k into c. As k and c both are integers, then k dash is again a integer. Okay, this one can be written as subtract the term of bc on both sides. We get ac minus bc is equal to n k dash. Now as here ac minus bc is a multiple of n, then by definition of divisibility, n divides the difference of two integers ac and bc. As n divides the difference of two terms ac and bc, then by definition of congruence, ac is congruent to bc modulo n. Okay, so here we have proved that if a is congruent to b modulo n, then a into c is congruent to b into c modulo n for some arbitrary integer c. So if a is congruent to b modulo n, then a plus c is congruent to b plus c modulo n, and a into c is congruent to b into c modulo n. Yeah. So fifth one is true. Now we have to see the sixth one. In sixth one, given that a is congruent to b modulo n, and we have to prove that a to the power k is congruent to b to the power k modulo n for some positive integer k. Positive means it must be greater equal by 1 for some positive integer k. That is, k must be greater equal by 1. So as we have to prove that a to the power k is congruent to b to the power k modulo n, here we will use the mathematical induction on the positive integer k. Here we use the mathematical induction to prove the result. Mathematical induction on K to prove the result. We first prove the result is true for k equal to 1. In second step, we will assume that the result is true for some k equal to m. And in third step, if we will prove the result is true for k equal to m plus 1, then we say that the result is true for any arbitrary integer k which is greater equal by 1. Okay, now in step 1, for k equal to 1, that is, here we have to prove that the result is true for k equal to 1. If k is equal to 1, then this one is nothing but, which implies a is congruent to b modulo n, and this one is trivially false, since this is trivially false, since already given that a is congruent to b modulo n. As a is congruent to b modulo n, then if k equal to 1, then the result already false, since here given that a is congruent to b modulo n. And here we will use the mathematical induction on k. As if we take the value of k equal to 1, then a is congruent to b modulo n, and this one is true, obviously. Okay, now in step 2, we have to assume that the result holds for n equal to m, k equal to m. That is, a to the power m is congruent to b to the power m modulo n. Now we have to prove that the result is also true for k equal to m plus 1. To prove that the result holds for n equal to m plus 1, that is, a to the power m plus 1 is congruent to b to the power m plus 1 modulo n. Okay, now for that, from step 2, a to the power m is congruent to b to the power m modulo n, and also given that, let us take this one as equation 4, a is congruent to b modulo n. Okay, let us take this one as equation 5. Now we know that one result. We know that if A is congruent to B modulo n and C is congruent to D modulo n, then A into C is congruent to B into D modulo n. Now we have to use these results here for equation 4 and 5. As if A is congruent to B modulo n and C is congruent to D modulo n, then we have proved that A into C is congruent to B into D modulo n. As from equation 4 and 5, A to the power m is congruent to B to the power m modulo n, and A to the power a is congruent to B modulo n, which implies A to the power m into A is congruent to B to the power m into B modulo n. This is from the above result, that is star, okay, which is from star. Okay, so as a to the power m into a is congruent to b to the power m into b modulo n, which implies this one is nothing but a to the power m into a to the power a, that is a to the power m into a to the power n is nothing but a to the power m plus n, that is here n equal to 1. A to the power m plus 1 congruent to b to the power m plus 1 modulo n. So here we have proved that the result is true for n equal to k, k equal to m plus 1, which implies the result is true for k equal to m plus 1. So from step 1, 2 and 3, therefore from step 1, 2 and 3, the result holds for all the positive integers k. Integers k, that is a to the power k is congruent to b to the power k modulo n whenever k is a positive integer, any positive integer. So in this we have proved that if a is congruent to b modulo n, then a to the power k is congruent to b to the power k modulo n, and hence the in doubt?
No sir.
So here
no, sir.
All this, okay, so here we have proved the all the 6 properties, that is if n greater than 1 be any fixed integer, as n is greater than 1, then it must be a positive integers, and a, b, c and d are any arbitrary integers, then the following 6 properties holds. That is, first one is a is congruent to a modulo n. In second one we have proved that it is a symmetric That is, if A is congruent to B modulo n, then B must be congruent to A modulo n. In third one, if A is congruent to B modulo n and B is congruent to C modulo n, then A is congruent to C modulo n. In fourth one, if A is congruent to B modulo n and C is congruent to D modulo n, then addition of left hand side is congruent to addition of right hand side. That is, A plus C is congruent to B plus D modulo n and A into C is congruent to B to D modulo n. And in fifth one, if A is congruent to B modulo n, then A plus C is congruent to B plus C modulo n and A into C is congruent to B into C modulo n for some arbitrary integer C. And in sixth one, if A is congruent to B modulo n, then A to the power K is congruent to B to the power K modulo n for some positive integer K. Now, in fifth property, there is one known K. In fifth property, we have proved that if A is congruent to B modulo n, then A into C is congruent to B into C modulo n for some arbitrary integer C. For some arbitrary integer C. What about it? Its converse. If suppose A C is congruent to B C modulo n, then whether A is congruent to B modulo n? पाचव्या प्रॉपर्टी मध्ये आपण काय केलं, ए हा कॉंग्रुएंट असेल जर बी मॉड्यूलो एन ला, तर आपण काय प्रूव्ह केलं, ए इंटू सी इज कॉंग्रुएंट टू बी इंटू सी मॉड्यूलो एन फॉर एनी आर्बिट्री इंटीजर सी. आता काय चेक करायचं आहे, जर समजा ए सी हा म्हणजे ए सी हा कॉंग्रुएंट असेल बी सी मॉड्यूलो एन ला, तर आपल्याला हे सांगायचं आहे की ए जो आहे तो कॉंग्रुएंट असेल का बी मॉड्यूलो एन ला. असेल का? हो नाही का सांगता येत नाही, काही असू शकतो, असूही शकतो नसूही शकतो.
यस सर इट कॅन.
यस सर इट कॅन. इट इज.
यस, इफ सपोज ए सी इज कॉंग्रुएंट टू बी सी मॉड्यूलो एन, देन ए मस्ट बी कॉंग्रुएंट टू बी मॉड्यूलो एन.
देन ए इज कॉंग्रुएंट टू बी मॉड्यूलो एन.
असेल ना?
हो सर.
यस सर.
म्हणजे कन्वर्स पार्ट पण ट्रू आहे, म्हणजे इफ अँड ओनली इफ असेल का, इफ ए इज कॉंग्रुएंट टू बी मॉड्यूलो ए इज कॉंग्रुएंट टू बी मॉड्यूलो एन, इफ अँड ओनली इफ ए सी इज कॉंग्रुएंट टू बी सी मॉड्यूलो एन, असं म्हणू शकतो का? मग म्हणू शकतो का?
हो सर
म्हणू शकतो. ठीक आहे. ओके, एक एक्झाम्पल देऊ आपण. Let or whether 2 into 4 is congruent to 2 into 1 modulo 6. Whether this one is true. Whether 2 into 4 is congruent to 2 into 1 modulo 6.
Yes, sir.
Okay. 4 into 2 is nothing but 8. 8 minus 2, 6. And 6 divides 6, which implies 2 into 4 is congruent to 2 modulo 6. Okay, now this is of the type, this one is nothing but this is of the type AC is congruent to BC modulo n. What is the value of C here? That is 2 into 4 is congruent to 2 into 1 modulo 6. So, C is nothing but so
2.
C equal to 2. Now we have to check whether A is congruent to B modulo n. What is A? A is nothing but 4. Is congruent to what is the value of B?
1 2 1.
Now check whether 4 is congruent to 1 modulo 6.
Yes sir.
Whether 6 divides 4 minus 1, which is 3.
No
sir.
Whether 6 divides 4 minus 1, that is 6 divides 3, whether this one is true. As 6 does not divide 3, which implies 4 is not congruent to 1 modulo 6. म्हणजे म्हणू शकतो का, जर ए सी हा कॉंग्रुएंट असेल बी सी मॉड्यूलो एन ला, तर ए कॉंग्रुएंट असेल का बी मॉड्यूलो एन ला?
नो सर.
नसेल ना?
काय म्हणलं?
डिपेंड ऑन
पॉसिबिलिटी
नाहीच होत ना, तुम्ही होईल म्हणले म्हणून मी तुम्हाला काउंटर एक्झाम्पल दिला. जर एसी हा कॉंग्रुएंट असेल बीसी मॉड्युलो यांना, तर हा नेसेसरी नाही आहे की ए हा कॉंग्रुएंट असेल बी मॉड्युलो यांना, हा त्याला काउंटर एक्झाम्पल होईल. ओके, सो फ्रॉम दिस वन वी से दॅट इफ ए इज कॉंग्रुएंट टू बी मॉड्युलो एन, देन A into C is congruent to B into C modulo N. But converse need not be, converse need not be true. Kunal, काही डाउट आहे मध्ये?
No sir.
Okay. Now if suppose AC is congruent to BC modulo N, then A is congruent to B modulo N for which integer? That is where what changes will be happens on the, that is modulo N. Instead of modulo N, some changes are open. For that, let us take, that is next theorem. If AC is congruent to BC modulo N, then A is congruent to B modulo N upon D, where D is the GCD of C and N. So for converse, if AC is congruent to BC modulo N, then A must be congruent to B modulo N upon D whenever D is nothing but the GCD of these two integers C and N. That is we have to prove. Let us see its proof. Okay. Here, given that AC is congruent to BC modulo N, as AC is congruent to BC modulo N, which implies N divides AC minus BC, which is from definition of congruence. Which implies N into some K is equal to AC minus BC for some integer K. For some integer k, that is, this can be written as n into k is equal to c into a minus b. Let us take this one as equation one. Okay, now as here given that b is nothing but the GCD of c and n, as b is the GCD of c and n. As B is the greatest common divisor of these two integers C and N, then by the definition of GCD, B must divide C and N. Okay. Now, as D divides C and D divides N, which implies there exist relatively prime integers R and S, relatively prime integers R and yes, such that C is nothing but D into R and N is nothing but D into S. Since D divides C and D divides N, which implies there exist relatively prime integers R and S, such that C is a multiple of D and N is also a multiple of D. That is, C is nothing but D into R and N is nothing but D into S. Now we have to put the values of C and N in equation 1. We get, put the values of C and N in equation 1, we get C equal to D into R and N equal to D into S. Okay, which implies N equal to D into S, D into S into K is equal to C is D into R into A minus B. Okay. Now, whether we can cancel D on both side. D cancel करू शकतो का? नक्की ना?
Yes sir.
कॅन्सल करू शकतो दोन्हीकडे आहे म्हणून इकडे तिकडे कॅन्सल करायचं.
डी ने डिवाइड करू शकतो आपण दोन्ही साइडला.
नक्की का? जर डी झिरो असेल तर
नॉट पॉसिबल.
वाय? इफ सपोज डी झिरो देन वेदर वी कॅन डिवाइड एनी इंटीजर बाय झिरो?
नो सर.
मग कॅन्सल करू शकतो का दोन्ही साइडला डी ने डिवाइड करू शकतो का आपण? मग
सर डी इज अ जीसीडी ऑफ एन एंड सी ना. जीसीडी थोडी ना झिरो.
इफ जीसीडी इज इफ डी इज अ जीसीडी देन
जीसीडी इज नॉट झिरो.
नक्की ना?
यस सर.
जीसीडी कधी झिरो नसतो ना. ग्रेटेस्ट कॉमन डिवायझर आहे. ऑलवेज तो पॉझिटिव्ह आहे काही का असेना तो मॉड्युलस ऑफ के. ओके म्हणजे डी डिवाइड करू शकतो का? डी इक्वल टू झिरो कधीच पॉसिबल नाहीये म्हणजे तो ऑलवेज पॉझिटिव्हच आहे म्हणजे मी डिवाइड करू शकतो.
यस.
Which yes, implies sir. S into K is equal to R into A minus B. Now, this integer R into A minus B is a multiple of S, which implies S divides R into A minus B. Okay? R into A minus B, हा S चा multiple मदे, S चा multiple मदे असेल, तर by definition of divisibility, S divides R into A minus B. Okay? Now, as given that R and S are relatively prime integers, as R and S are relatively prime integers, relatively prime integers. What is meant by relatively prime integers?
GCD of two numbers is one.
That is, GCD of R and S is equal to one. So here, S divides R into A minus B and GCD of S and R is 1. From this one, what is possible? What is Euclid's lemma? Euclid's lemma, if A divides B into C and GCD of AB equal to 1, then?
A divides C.
That is, let us write it here, this. Euclid's lemma. What is Euclid's lemma? If A divides B into C and GCD of A comma B is equal to 1, then A must divides C. Okay, which is from the Euclid's lemma. So as here, S divides R into A minus B and GCD of R and S equal to 1, which implies?
S divides A minus B.
By Euclid's lemma, S divides A minus B. As S divides A minus B, then by the definition of congruence, A is congruent to B modulo S, which is from definition of congruence. What is the value of S? As n equal to d into S. N equal to d into S, which implies S is nothing but n upon d. And this one is possible since d is always positive. Therefore, S equal to n upon d. So we have to put the value of S, which implies A is congruent to B modulo n upon d, since S is equal to n upon d, which implies if AC is congruent to BC modulo n, then A is congruent to B modulo n upon d, where d is the GCD of C and n, and hence the proof. Any doubt? कुणाला काही डाउट असेल तर सांग. नक्की ना? नक्की नाही येणार डाउट? ओके, मग एक डाउट माझं क्लिअर करा. जर समजा एसी हा कॉंग्रुएंट आहे बी सी मॉड्युलो एन ला, तर असं कधीतरी पॉसिबल आहे का ए हा कॉंग्रुएंट असेल बी मॉड्युलो एन ला? काय आहे तुमच्याकडे? एसी हा कॉंग्रुएंट आहे बी सी मॉड्युलो एन ला, तर हे कधी पॉसिबल आहे का नाही ए हा कॉंग्रुएंट असेल बी मॉड्युलो एन ला?
येस सर.
नक्की ना?
व्हेन डी इज वन.
D is 1, that is if GCD of C and N is equal to 1, then A is congruent to B modulo N.
Yes, sir.
Corollary. If AC is congruent to BC modulo N, then A is congruent to B modulo N, where GCD of C and N is equal to 1. आला प्रूव कसं करणार आपण? प्रूव कसं करायचं याला? Suppose we have AC is congruent to BC modulo N, then we have to prove that A is congruent to B modulo N, where GCD of CN will be equal to 1. How will you prove this one?
Replace the D by 1, above theorem we get the answer.
Replacing D by 1 in above theorem. Then we get the required result. Nakki ka? Replace ke liye andar milel na?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, next corollary, second one is, if AC is congruent to BC modulo P, where P is prime number, then A is congruent to B modulo P whenever. He got it true. होईल का कधी असं ट्रू? हे कसं प्रूव्ह करणार? AC is congruent to BC modulo P, where P is nothing but prime number, then we have to prove that A is congruent to B modulo N, B modulo P, whenever P does not divide C. How will you prove this one? Approve होणार होईल का नाही प्रूव्ह? हा होत असेल तर कसं होईल सांगा?
पी आणि सी चा जीसीडी वनच येणार ना?
काय म्हणलात? नक्की येतो का?
प्राइम में आ
यस सर
तो डिवाइड कर
वेयर जीसीडी ऑफ पी एंड सी इज इक्वल टू 1 नक्की का कशावर
हो सर
हो सर
यस सर
पी प्राइम
पी डज नॉट डिवाइड
सी डिवाइड सी
हां मग पी डज नॉट डिवाइड सी म्हणजे सी हा पी च्या मल्टीपल मध्ये नाही
यस सर असंच का
म्हणजे पी हा सी हा पी च्या मल्टीपल मध्ये नाहीये पण पी हा सी च्या मल्टीपल मध्ये असू शकतो ना सी नहीं है ठीक है पी डज नॉट डिवाइड सी म्हणजे सी हा त्याच्या मल्टीपल मध्ये नाहीये पण पी असू शकतो की सी च्या मल्टीपल मध्ये सी जर लहान असेल तर पी पेक्षा
बट सर पी इज प्राइम नंबर
हां प्राइमच आहे हो
प्राइम नंबर्स cannot be expressed as multiples of
some other number नक्की का
हो सर
म्हणजे जर सी सी हा पी पेक्षा लहान असेल तर सी साठी पॉसिबिलिटी काय असतील काही का असेना सी हा पी च्या इक्वल तर कधीच नसेल पी च्या इक्वल तर कधी नसेल कारण पी डिवाइड करत नाहीये सी ला म्हणजे तो सी हा पी च्या इक्वल तर नाहीये म्हणजे तो काय असू शकतो असेल तरी 1 असेल ना
1
आणि जर 1 जरी असेल तर जीसी ऑफ 1 आहे आणि एडी प्राइम इज नथिंग बट 1
1
म्हणजे हा ऍक्च्युअली तुम्हाला काय दिले एसी इज कॉंग्रूएंट टू बीसी मॉड्यूलो पी दिलाय हा पी पी प्राइम नंबर आहे आणखीन काय दिले जीसीडी ऑफ पी एंड सी इक्वल टू 1 दिले पी डज नॉट डिवाइड सी म्हणजे जीसीडी ऑफ पी एंड सी विल बी इक्वल टू 1 जर असं असेल तर अबो थेरम यूज करू शकतो का आपण म्हणजे कॉरोलरी 1 एसी इज कॉंग्रूएंट टू बीसी मॉड्यूलो पी एंड जीसीडी ऑफ पी एंड सी इज इक्वल टू 1 व्हिच इंप्लाइज ए इज कॉंग्रूएंट टू बी मॉड्यूलो पी म्हणू शकतो का
यस सर
यस सर
यस सर
Now, show that 41 divides 2 to the power 20 minus 1. Here we have to show that 41 divides 2 to the power 20 minus 1 by using the congruence theory. How will you prove this one? Okay, now here, what is the value of 2 to the power of 5? 81,
32.
Okay, 32 is congruent to under modulo 41. 41 होण्यासाठी या 32 ला आणखीन किती कमी?
9.
म्हणजे 32 congruent कशाला असेल? कमी आहे याचा अर्थ तो मायनस नाईन ला कॉंग्रुएंट असेल विच इम्प्लाइज दॅट इज नथिंग बट 2 to the power 5 हा कॉंग्रुएंट कशाला आहे मायनस ऑफ 9 मॉड्युलो 41 पण तुम्हाला कुठपर्यंत घेऊन जायचं आहे 2 to the power 20 पर्यंत घेऊन जायचं आहे लेट अस टेक एज वी हॅव ऑलरेडी प्रूव्ह दॅट इफ ए इज कॉंग्रुएंट टू बी मॉड्युलो एन ओके
विच इम्प्लाइज
ए टू द पॉवर के इज कॉंग्रुएंट टू बी टू द पॉवर के मॉड्युलो एन ओके नाउ जर तुम्हाला या टर्मला 2 to the power 20 पर्यंत घेऊन जायचं असेल तर के काय घ्यावं लागेल
4
2 to the power 5 raised to 4 इज कॉंग्रुएंट टू मायनस ऑफ 9 to the power 4 मॉड्युलो 41 ओके विच इज नथिंग बट हे काय येईल 2 to the power 5 to the power 4
2 to the power 20
येईल का 2 to the power 5 raised to 4 येईल
2 to the power 20
नक्की ना
यस सर
इज कॉंग्रुएंट टू मायनस ऑफ 9 square इनटू मायनस ऑफ 9 square व्हिच इज नथिंग एज द पॉवर इज पॉझिटिव्ह सॉरी इवन नंबर इट मस्ट बी एन पॉझिटिव्ह दॅट इज 9 to the power 4 9 to the power 4 कॅन बी रिटन एज 9 square इनटू 9 square व्हिच इज नथिंग बट मॉड्युलो 41 व्हिच इज नथिंग बट 2 to the power 20 इज कॉंग्रुएंट टू 9 square इज नथिंग बट 81 इनटू 81 मॉड्युलो 41 का असं काही डाऊट आहे हे 81 into 81 का घेतलं 81 का आला घ्यायचं लहान कारण तुम्हाला ओव्हर मॉड्युलो 41 चेक करायचं आहे म्हणजे तुम्हाला 81 हा 41 किती मल्टिपल मध्ये आहे ते लवकर काढता येईल म्हणून असं घ्यायचं ओके बट 81 इज कॉंग्रुएंट टू मॉड्युलो 41 81 ला किती कमी
मायनस
1 ला असेल ना. ओके अँड ऑल्सो 81 सेकंड 81 इज ऑल्सो कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू मायनस ऑफ 1 मॉड्युलो 41 विच इम्प्लाइज 81 इंटू 81 इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू ए इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू बी मॉड्युलो एन and c is congruent to d modulo n, then a into c is congruent to b into d modulo n, that is 81 into 81 is congruent to minus of 1 into minus of 1 modulo 41, and this is nothing but 81 into 81 is congruent to minus 1 into minus 1, which is plus 1 modulo 41. Okay, now 2 to the power 20 is congruent to 81 into 81 modulo 41, and 81 into 81 is congruent to 1 modulo 41, that is A is congruent to B modulo N and B is congruent to C modulo N. Then by the transitivity, time
A is congruent to C modulo N.
1 modulo 41. Okay, which is from this property, that is which property? If A is congruent to B modulo N.
Transitivity.
A is congruent to B mod N and B is congruent to C modulo N, then A is congruent to C modulo N. Whether from this we say that 41 divides 2 to the power 20 minus 1. Yachyavarun manu shakto ka 41 ha 2 to the power 20 minus 1 la divide karel?
Yes sir.
Nakki ka? Which implies? Yes, sir. 41 divides 2 to the power 20 minus 1, which is from
congruence
definition of congruence. कोणाला काही डाउट असतील तर सांगा. आतापर्यंत आजच्या लेक्चर मध्ये किंवा लास्ट लेक्चर मध्ये कोणाला काही डाऊट असेल तर सांग. नाही आहेत का?
नो सर.
अबो रिझल्ट वरून काही एक्झाम्पल बघू आपण. दॅट इज इफ एसी इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू बीसी मॉड्युलो एन, देन ए इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू बी मॉड्युलो एन अपॉन डी, वेअर डी इज द जीसीडी ऑफ सी एन. ओके, कन्सिडर द कॉन्ग्रुएंस, कन्सिडर द कॉन्ग्रुएंस इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू 15 मॉड्युलो 9. Okay, now here we have to use the above result. This 33 here, given that 33 is congruent to 15 modulo 9. Now this 33 congruent to 15 modulo 9 can be written in the form of A into C congruent to B into C modulo N. That is, this one can be written as 11 into 3 congruent to 5 into 3 modulo 9. लिहू शकतो ना सर?
Yes sir. 11
into 3 33, 5 into 3 15. Now here the value of C is nothing but 3. Now we have to use the result. If AC is congruent to BC modulo N, then A is congruent to B modulo N upon D, where D is the GCD of CN. From that result काय लिहू शकतो आपण? As here 11 into 3 is congruent to 5 into 3 modulo 9, which implies what is the value of A? A is nothing but 11 and B is nothing but 5, which implies 11 is congruent to 5 modulo 9. 9 is nothing but N divided by GCD of C and N. What is the value of C?
3.
And N is nothing but?
9.
So 11 congruent to 5 modulo 9 upon GCD of 3 and 9, which is nothing but 11 is congruent to 5 modulo 9. GCD of 3 and 9?
3.
Which implies 11 is congruent to 5 modulo 9 by 3, 3. Whether this one is true? 11 minus 5 is 6. And 3 divides 6, which implies as 3 divides the difference of 11 and 5, then 11 must be congruent to 5 modulo 3. Now, from this one, we check whether minus 35 is congruent to 45 modulo 8. Hey, check karun sanga. Whether minus 35 is congruent to 45 modulo 8. Minus 35 as here given that minus of 35 is congruent to 45 modulo 8. We have to use above result, then minus 35 can be written as asa kahi tari multiple sanga 35 and 45 madhe common ala paije je kitni karun apnala c ci value mile
7 into 5
नक्की का
माइनस
7 इनटू 5
माइनस
7 इनटू 5
माइनस 7 इनटू
माइनस 7 इनटू 5 इक्वल टू
9 इनटू 5
मॉड्यूलो 8. नाउ हियर वी गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ सी व्हिच इज 5. ए सी इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू बी सी मॉड्यूलो n, व्हिच इंप्लाइज minus 7
is congruent to 8
divided by GCD of
five and eight.
What is the value of GCD of 5 and 8?
1.
Whether they are relatively prime?
Yes, yes sir.
Yes. Minus 7 is congruent to 9 modulo 8 divided by 1, since 5 and 8 are relatively prime, which implies -7 is congruent to 9 modulo. म्हणजे ही एक केस असेल का ज्यामध्ये तुम्हाला जर ए सी हा कॉन्ग्रुएंट असेल बी सी मॉड्यूलो एन ला, तर ही हा डायरेक्ट कॉन्ग्रुएंट मिळेल बी मॉड्यूलो एन ला. जीसीडी ऑफ सी अँड एन 1 आहे ना इथं.
यस सर. यस सर.
अशी केस मिळाली ना तुम्हाला, इफ ए सी इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू बी सी मॉड्यूलो एन, देन ए इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू बी मॉड्यूलो एन. हे प्रत्येक केस साठी ट्रू नाहीये, पण कुठे ट्रू आहे, जर जीसीडी ऑफ सी अँड एन विल बी इक्वल टू 1, एज हियर जीसीडी ऑफ 5 अँड 8 दैट इज जीसीडी ऑफ सी एन विल बी इक्वल टू 1, देयरफॉर ए मस्ट बी कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू बी मॉड्यूलो एन. ओके, ना कुणाला काही डाउट असतील तर सांगा, नाहीतर आजचं लेक्चर थांबवू.